The first setting we'll be taking a look at is image quality. Image quality controls the overall quality of the game. This is one of the most important settings in the game because what you set it at can determine whether or not you'll be able to continue to play on your save. So if you start a skirmish game on low, then you won't be able to load into that same skirmish game if you set your image quality to medium or high. And the same is true vice versa. So if you start a skirmish game on either medium or high, then you won't be able to load that in if you turn it down to low. I'm not sure why it's locked behind these walls. It's very weird, but it's just something you need to be aware of so you don't put a lot of hours into a save that you then cannot access if you want to turn up or down your image quality. Image quality seems to be a bit of a weird setting because in a way it's a preset, because if you turn it down to low, then it will disable any other setting you have. And the only other setting you will actually be able to change after you have turned image quality down to low is the shadow settings. However, if you turn it up to medium or high, this does not affect any of the other settings. Now you can actually change them though, but they are still set to either low or off as they were when you have image quality at low. So those two options does not seem to be presets, but they do make a difference. In my testing here, I did not change any other setting than image quality. However, you can clearly see that medium and high looks a lot better than low does. So it must be doing something special in the background that you cannot replicate yourself. For my recommendation, I would recommend to use medium, because between medium and high, I don't see any difference in quality or performance. However, you do use a little bit more VRAM in high. So to save that VRAM, you might as well just set this to medium. Hello ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to my video. Today we're taking a look at Age of Empires 4. We will take a look at all the different settings, how they compare in terms of FPS and quality, and lastly I'll show my own optimized settings that I recommend. If you have any suggestions for future games you would like for me to analyze, feel free to write them in the comments below. Firstly, I wanted to showcase the two extremes for all low and all ultra to see both the performance and the quality difference between the two. There's a few points I want to mention before we move on to the next setting. Firstly, you need to restart your game after changing any of the graphical settings in this game, which can be quite annoying. Therefore, I recommend that you change multiple of them at a time to save some time. Secondly, this game is badly optimized on your CPU, and therefore your performance can vary a lot. Lastly, I also want to mention that even at 4K, I never used above 6GB of VRAM, which means that this game does not use that much VRAM, which is pretty nice. As you can see in the video, there's a 64% difference between all low and all ultra, so we have a lot of headroom we can work with. So let's get started. Now let's take a look at animation quality. Animation quality controls the quality of the different animations in-game. So these will be the animations from your different soldiers, horsemen, and so on. In my testing, however, I have not been able to find any difference in either quality of the animations nor in performance. As you can see, there really isn't any noticeable difference between any of these three options. Therefore, I would simply recommend to just leave this at high, because you're not gonna lose any performance from doing so. Next up, we got shadow quality. Shadow quality controls the quality of the different shadows inside the game. One thing you might already have noticed though is that there is no performance difference between having this turned off and all the way up to high. Another thing you might notice is that even though I set it to off, it doesn't actually turn the shadows, you know, off. They're still there. It's basically the same as having it on high, it seems. Which is a bit weird because previously when I tested image quality, you could see that I clearly had my shadows turned off. So you can turn them off, you just need to do a little bit of a workaround. If you then take a look at my second example here, you can see that this time I actually have my shadows turned off, and that actually makes a performance difference, as it should, because my shadows are now turned off. So now you can see that we have around 4% difference between off and low, medium and high. Low, medium, high seem to be more or less the same across the board. Now you're probably wondering, how did I do that? So I'm just gonna quickly go through this and show you how to do it. Firstly, you need to come into your settings menu and change your overall image quality to low. Once you have done that, you just need to restart the game to have it take effect. After you have restarted the game, you can then set image quality to wherever you like. I recommended medium, so I'm gonna go with medium, but this will also work for high. Then you will be able to change all the other settings as you please, except for shadow settings. The only one you should not change anything about is the shadow quality. So for this experiment, I've just turned everything up to the highest. Once you have done that, you need to restart the game again to have all these different changes take effect. After we have restarted the game, I just quickly checked that everything is as it should be. And one thing to note is that shadow quality is actually set to low. It's not set to off. It's actually set to low from when we set image quality to low. But as you can see here, while I load into the first campaign mission, my shadows are off. And I gained a performance difference from it. This does not make any sense, since my shadow quality is still technically set to low. It's not set to off. But this is the only way I found so far that you can actually turn the shadows off. Because if you just try to set them to off, that won't do anything. For my recommendation for this setting, I would simply just recommend to leave it at high. Because there's no quality or performance difference between low and high. It's only when you do what I just told you to turn it off that you actually see any performance difference. And turning shadows completely off on a game like this can make it look very bland and ugly to look at, to be honest. And it's not worth the 3-4% performance. Now let's take a look at texture detail. Texture detail controls the details of the different textures inside the game. As you can see, we have a big difference between low and medium, where low is a lot more blurry, both in terms of on the items, but also on the ground itself. Between medium and high, I didn't really notice any noticeable difference between the two in terms of quality, though we do lose around 2% more performance. Another thing to note is that this will also have a big impact on your VRAM usage. Where you can see between low and medium we use around 16% extra VRAM, and between low and high we use around 22% extra VRAM. Therefore, I would recommend to use medium, because with medium you're able to remove most of, if not all of, the different blurry textures from the game without using too much VRAM. Now let's take a look at geometric detail. Geometric detail controls the amount of polygons used for certain objects in the game. I expected this to have a big difference with either the trees or the soldiers, where it would make a big difference in terms of the qualities of these items. However, in my testing, I have not been able to find a single place where this actually makes a difference in terms of quality. And since I did find around 6-7% performance difference, I would honestly recommend to just leave this at low, because in terms of quality, you don't seem to be missing out, and this will allow you to gain around 6-7% extra performance. Next up, we got anti-aliasing. Anti-aliasing removes jagged edges from different objects in the game, making them look smoother and generally just making the game look a lot sharper and better. As per usual, I have tested this both in 4K, 1440p and 1080p, because my recommendation will differentiate depending on the resolution you're playing in. If we start up with 4K, I actually couldn't see any difference between having this turned off and having it turned up to high. Therefore, I would simply recommend to leave anti-aliasing off if you're playing in 4K. If we then take a look at 1440p, we are starting to see some jagged edges on the different soldiers and some of the items in the game. Therefore, I would actually recommend to set this to as a minimum of low, maybe even high if you can, but I would highly recommend to set this to low to remove the worst of the jagged edges. And finally, if you take a look at 1080p, here I would actually recommend you turn it all the way up to high. I do know that we're gonna lose around 10% of our performance from doing so, but because we're in such a low resolution, we actually need this to have a much sharper and better looking image while playing the game. And therefore, I also think it's worth it setting this too high. And lastly, we got physics. Physics determines the amount of detail in different debris in the game. So that debris will mostly come from you destroying other buildings or your own buildings being destroyed. In this, I have tested two scenarios. In my first scenario here, I wanted to test if it would actually make a difference in terms of the quality, in terms of the amount of debris and the amount of different level of destruction on the buildings. However, as you can see, it doesn't seem to make any difference in quality whatsoever, and my performance was also the same. In my second example here, I wanted to destroy several buildings at once to see if that would have any difference on my performance. But as you can see, once again, this has no difference at all at my performance and didn't really make any difference at quality either. Therefore, I would simply recommend to just leave this at high, since it doesn't seem to make any difference whatsoever in either quality or performance. Here are my own recommended settings, which are based off the recommendations I have made throughout the video. Do keep in mind that you have to adapt anti-aliasing based on your resolution. So for 1080p, I recommend to use high. For 1440p, I recommend low. And for 4K, I recommend to just turn it off. And here is the live showcase of my recommended settings stacked up against all low and all ultra. As you can see, we have the same quality as all ultra, while having almost 23% more FPS and using 15% less VRAM, which is just great. But thank you all for watching. If you made it this far and been able to use this video to get better FPS in Age of Empires 4, please like and subscribe for future videos where we'll take a look at other games. If you had any feedback on the videos or any other tips or tricks to get more FPS in Age of Empires 4, please share them in the comments below. If you're interested in these kinds of videos, maybe check out the video I made on New World. Have a nice day. Bye bye.